So I decided to continue playing with this coffee making example and decided that we need to make it even more complicated just to try out a few other ideas. So here's what I've got now. Same coffee maker as the main entry point into the system. I've elaborated a bit, so it's got a selector panel where I choose the different types of coffees. It's got a display to show what I'm currently selecting. The brew unit is the same as before. I've added statistics so that I can keep track of how many number of coffees that I've brewed. The brewer as before, the water boiler, the grinder. I've added a coffee container to keep track of how much coffee I've got in the machine at the moment. I've added a water pump to get water. This machine is apparently connected to the water mains, otherwise I would have to have some way to check how much water is available at the moment as well. There's the trash container for the beans. So once you've ground them and used them, you put them in the trash, and then you need to check if this is full, and then you need to give a warning that it's time to empty it. The mixer and the milk container is as before, and I've added a barista as well. So if you want more fancy types of coffee, you can plug in different baristas here, and you can have different types of coffee. And basically, what you do is that you present a list of different coffees that this barista unit can do to the coffee maker, so you can select them, and then you get information about how much coffee, how much milk, how much if there's any sugar or whatever. So you get that in a struct, the information on how to brew it. I just did this so that I will have a somewhat more classes to play with. It's still possible to you can fit this on one page, so it's still possible to work with, but it's getting a bit unruly and wily there. So what we should do is that we should start thinking about how can we put this into different clusters, and what we'll do then is that we'll use the package notation. See if I remember it. With a bit of luck, this should do the trick. Oh yes. Difficult to see, but it's over here. We have now a package called user interface with the coffee maker and all that's inside the so the coffee maker, the selector panel, and the display. Then we can go ahead and let's see what should be reasonable packages here. So brew unit is, let's see, what can we do? We can do with the brew unit is in one package at least. Let's call it the brew function. That puts the brew unit. Actually, I don't think I have to have everything except the class names in there. Let's put the brewer inside there as well. Possibly the grinder. No, actually no. The barista. Well, that's a pluggable thing, so let's keep that outside. Let's do one which we call hardware controllers. That's where we put the water boiler, the grinder, and the mixer. We have one which we can call hardware selectors or hardware sensors. That's where we read information. So we have the milk container. We've got the water, not a water pump, is in the hardware controllers. The coffee container, the bean trash, compile and see how this works. Good. Statistics and barista is still outside, and the service unit. The service unit should probably be under hardware controllers, right? Let's put the barista unit in something called plugins. And have a data storage for the statistics unit. Compile and see. Very good. Only very big as well. I wonder if this is as easy as that. Yes, it was. Ha! Who knew? Well, 0.4 is probably 2.7. There we go. So what we've done now is that we've added packages. The user interface is one package. The brew is another package. Contains everything that's got to do with the brew. And then everything that actually is communicating with the hardware and telling it to do stuff is in something called hardware controllers. The service unit might not be there. It might be better to put that into the brew, possibly. And then we have a couple of classes that read stuff. The hardware sensors, the bean trash, the milk container, and the coffee container. I've put them under sensors. And since I wanted a pluggable architecture with the barista, I put that in something called plugins. Now, it's still on one page. Still about as difficult to get an overview as of as before, or slightly better. These square boxes, or these black boxes, actually make somewhat of a difference. But the point is that I can now raise the level. So I can now make a different version of this, where I'm only talking about the different packages. So let's do that. So yeah, I've got the user interface. Data store. And the plugins. And then I can start doing relations between these instead. Let's see if I remember the syntax for that. It should be as easy as before. Yes. That's the brew will have connections to the data store. And with the hardware controllers. And with the hardware sensors. apparently can't name this plugins with a hyphen in it, because that plant UML doesn't seem to like that. Ah, here we are. See if I can hide this temporarily to show you. So this means that if I just look at the packages, I can get a quick overview. We have a user interface, we have something called Brew, we have a data store, we have the hardware and controllers and sensors, and we have a plugin thingy which is connected to the Brew. There should be a line between user interface and plugins as well. And hardware controllers should have something with the hardware sensors, but that's doable. Let's see, let's add those. I really need to start to learn how to type. The plugins, and I said the hardware controllers and the hardware sensors, right? And there you have it. What I can do now, oh, I lost a bit of information, a bit of control here. Let's add that one. Good. So I can use this as an overview picture, saying that this is an overall architecture of the system. It consists of three layers. We have a user interface, we have some sort of domain logic, and then we have a hardware interaction, and we have data storage on the lower level. So it's a layered architecture suddenly. We can talk about this, we can talk about the different packages or modules, if you will. And then I can design each of them on a separate page. So let's say the hardware controllers had a few classes in it, with maybe more or less complex interactions between them. So I can put that on a separate page, and I can start designing this is what's inside the hardware controllers package. And then I will probably never put it together into one big picture like this. I will keep it separate. This is the design of the hardware controllers. This is the design of the Brew package. This is the design of the hardware sensors package. And then I can just refer back to this picture to get the overall. I can then do links between them. So if I've got, if I need inside hardware controllers, for example, I will need to have a look at something which is in hardware sensors, then I'll use the scope operator to access that, and that's okay. To be precise, this is how you would do it. We had something, we had the mixer, right? So here we have it. We have the mixer, which is belonging to the hardware controllers, and we have the milk container, but we also say that this is coming from the hardware sensors package. So that way we can tie in the classes we need to. These are typically the interface classes, the facade classes for other packages. And we don't have to actually have both the hardware controllers and the hardware sensors stuck on the same page. So this is how we go from something big and difficult to read into something which is gives an overview, and then you dig deeper into each individual package. And that is what I wanted to say about packages. Thank you.